about how the Orioles or the Shorebirds or the Ravens played this week, right? It's no big deal. You can just talk about it. I mean, it might be a big deal if they lost, but it's really no big deal when it comes to communication about it. You just talk about it, right? You talk about what you're going to do next week. The Lord gives you breath and gives you life. You don't lecture on it. You don't make a big headline announcement. You simply talk about it. You talk about what you plan to watch before the evening news. You don't hold classes on it. You just merely talk about it. There's an easygoing, natural flow of conversation, right? I mean, that's what happens when something is filling up your heart. It's just easy, natural flow of conversation. Can I tell you, folks, that's what makes your Christianity authentic. Talking like Jesus was never designed as just a Sunday lifestyle. No. Sunday and Monday and Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday and Friday and Saturday is a cycle of living for Jesus. As a matter of fact, if you just turn on some kind of Christian music to get you up for the moment on Sunday morning, oh my. If you just do certain things to get you ready for church Sunday morning, oh my. If conversation only becomes religious to you about 7:30 on Sunday morning, oh my. What makes Christianity authentic is because it is a natural, easy flow of conversation. It is what your heart is filled up with. And think about this. Wasn't that the instruction to parents and guardians from Moses? In Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 7 is on the big screen here for you. You shall teach them diligently to your children, and you shall talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up. That just about covers every day. From the moment you say, good morning, Lord, to the moment you say, good night, Lord. That's just about every hour of your day. You shall teach them. Teach what to them? The laws, the statutes, the goodness, the grace, the glory of God. You shall teach them to your children. And you shall what? Easily, naturally talk of them when you sit down in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up again. It should be healthy, natural talk. I think what happens is this, folks, and let me be very candid this morning with you. For too many years, we have left the responsibility of healthy talk to those who lead preschool, nursery, kids' church connection, small groups, and reality student ministries. We've left it up to somebody else who's more qualified than I am. Well, I'll just bring the kids and the teens, and somebody else will take care of the healthy talk for me. You shall teach them. Moses addressing parents and guardians. You shall teach them. Matter of fact, if our spouses and our children have never learned to forge relationships with others, it's because, it's admitted, we've miserably failed to pass along healthy talk. We've miserably failed to pass along healthy talk. Somewhere we have missed the mark how to encourage uplifting conversations and life-giving declarations to those who live under our roof, inside and outside of our walls. Somewhere we have neglected to provide our immediate sphere of influence with Bible-based models they need to forge relationships that easily, naturally talk about the Lord. Here's what we're really good at, folks. And we must be honest with ourselves in the presence of God this morning. We are very good at words of terminal illness. Words that neither edify or support. Words that neither build up, but words that tear down. We must model, and we must teach the things that will equip our spouse, equip our children for the future. I'm going to close with this because I think I'm going to have part two next week. I just got that feeling this morning in my heart, so we're going to come back to this again. But I want to close with a few things that I believe the Lord gave me. I'm going to let them settle in your spirit. I'm not going to call you to the altar to repent of them. You can do that where you are seated. But I want you to hear a couple of statements that I think the Lord gave me that should never be heard under your roof. I want you to avoid them at all costs. I want you to pray that prayer of David. Guard my mouth. Put a watch over the door of my lips. Avoid them at all costs because no one needs to hear these words. Let's establish something more before I give you these statements. How many of you know that words last? How many know that words have power?
That's right.
If we could take the time today in the service, we would be the rest of the day, and it would be healthy. But we could take the time right now to share one word or statement that was said over all of us somewhere back in the younger part of our life. And it is still a hurt to this day. It is still a hang-up to this day. And unfortunately, we have developed some habits because of that word. So let me give you a few statements. I will come back to this perhaps next Sunday. I just see a caution sign, a stop sign, the Holy Ghost. So I'm going to stop, resist, stop. How many times have you used or heard this word? Or the statement. Why can't you be more like? More like who? More like what? Every husband, every wife, every significant other, every child is implanted with unique divine design. Creator God has created those who are linked to you just as they are on purpose. They were never supposed to be just like somebody else. Another statement, just three words before it's powerful. At your age, what does that mean? What does that mean? And what is the spirit behind those three words? We've got a truckload of kids, and you know that. I think I understand that children do act their age. I've never met one that did not act their age. They're children. They are not adults. Children act like children. So don't ridicule a child for being what he or she is, and that is a child. How about this one? Is that really the best you can do? Is that really the best you can do? How many of you know this labeling is disabling? You tag somebody with something. You hang it around their neck for years. Labeling is disabling. Whether you are questioning their appearance or their performance, these words are seldom healthy. It is human nature, folks, to allow particular words to define us and also to limit us. So beware of using statements like you are the best or you are the worst. Or you're the cutest or you're the ugliest. Or you're the smartest or you are the dumbest. Those words disable. How about this one? How could you be so stupid? How could you be so stupid? It is okay once in a while, not habitually, but it's okay once in a while to call yourself stupid. Because sometimes we are, right? We do stupid stuff. We do careless things. We act before we think. But it's never healthy to say to somebody, how could you be so stupid? Stupid is terminal illness, let alone degrading. How about this one? I wish I never knew you. I wish I never laid eyes on you. Never use those words of terminal illness. In a moment of exasperation or fatigue, never, ever use those words. And then my all-time favorite, shut up. Why would you insult your intelligence? You have better vocabulary than those two words. There are many other ways to silence inappropriate outbursts and behavior in conversation. And how about this one? Do it or else. Else what? Else what? I mean, those words in itself are invitations to test your limits. How many parents are in the house this morning? I want to see your hands here. How many of you know by experience every child, no matter how good he or she is, they love to test your limits? That's not because they're evil. Because we're growing up. Hey, they learn that one real easy and real young, don't they? That's why no is used to come before yes. They've heard a lot of no, 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 no. So they just echo it back when we say, "Did you no, 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 no." And so we use that, you know, or else what? A threat without follow through is ineffective discipline. And if you have no biblical reason, then never threaten to leave your child or your husband or your wife. Never threaten that. I am so saddened by a new statement. I'm not sure exactly when it started. I didn't Google this one. But everybody's using it. I'm done with this. What do you mean you're done with this? You're not done till you draw your last breath. And you close your eyes beside of heaven. And Jesus takes you home. You can't be done with this if you're still breathing. What a cop-out. It's an easy escape. I'm done with this. I mean, who in their right mind would build their house on the sandy land? That's what I'm done with this means. Or else, that's what it means. So parents and guardians, let's do this one more time. We're close this morning. Let's look at Ephesians 4:29 one more time. Big screen, here we go. We're going to say it out loud. In fact, let's stand set out loud. Let's make this a matter of prayer this morning. I'll pick up from here next week. So come back for part two. Ready to read? Let's read the verse reference first. Verse of scripture, and then we're going to recite the scripture text. Here we go. Ephesians 4:29. Let no unwholesome, unhealthy word proceed from your mouth, but only such a word as is good for edification. One more time by yourself. Here we go. One more time. Let's go. Let
no unwholesome, unhealthy word proceed from your mouth, but only such a word as is good for edification.
Let's pray together. Father, I thank you that you are Father. Father of me and Father of all of us. You are the Father of all fathers and mothers and sons and daughters. Gracious Lord, sometimes our mouths speak words that dishonor you. Thank you that by your Spirit, our untamed tongue can be brought under divine control. From this day forward, based upon your truth, we read out loud this morning and responsibly share one another. Would you guard our mouth? Would you curb our careless speech? And would you speak only health from our lips, because you have already healed our heart? And would you do that, Father, from now to the day we face you in all of your glory, when we stand before you to be judged and rewarded by you. Put a guard over our mouth. Watch the door of our lips.
Yes.
Because we want healthy talk in our home.
Yes.
We want to be encouragers, uplifters, healers. We want to be deliverers. We want to be ambassadors. We want Christ to rule our heart, our home, and our tongue. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for challenging us today to grow up families in a breaking down world in a way that pleases Christ. We will give you honor and glory and praise, as God's people said. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God bless you. Have a great week in Jesus. Go forth in his power.